In this video, we will see some effect of color on like focal length and some different factors. So you can see that. We know that when white light passing through a prism, it splits into its constituent color, that is vPure. And violet color is at the bottom and red color is at the top. It means that deviation of violet color is maximum from the initial direction and deviation of red color is minimum. What is the cause of dispersion? Dispersion takes place because refractive index of the refractive medium, and in this case refractive medium is the our glass, the material with which the prism is made of, is different for different wavelength, that is color. Mu, that is refractive index of this prism, is not a constant quantity. Mu of the prism, that is refractive index of the prism, depends on the color. And we know that the Cauchy relation, mu equal to a plus b by lambda square. This is the relation between refractive index of the prism material and lambda, that is wavelength. And we know that red color has maximum wavelength and it keep on decreasing when we go towards violet. So from Cauchy theorem you can see that if lambda will be more, refractive index will be less. So order of refractive index will be inverse of the order of the wavelength. So the refractive index of less red color will be minimum and refractive index of violet color will be maximum. Or we can say that refractive index of the refractive medium is a function of color. For different color, refractive index will have different value. And for a thin prism, we know that deviation of the incident light is equal to a into mu minus 1, where a is the angle of the prism, mu is the refractive index, minus 1. Since mu is maximum for red color, mu is minimum for red color and mu is maximum for violet color, and mu is, you can see that somehow is proportional to mu. So if mu will be more, deviation will be more. So order of deviation will be in the order of mu. So deviation of red color will be less and it will keep on increasing if we'll go towards violet color. That's I already discussed earlier also. See, this is the deviation of red color, this is delta r, and this is the deviation of deviation of violet color. Now this concept we will use for the further study for today's discussion. Now one thing, remember that what do you mean by chromatic aberration? Till now we learned that when a white light falls, or when a ray of light passes through a prism, passes through a lens, through a convex lens, then it converges, or it passes through the focus of the lens. But in reality, what happens? In reality, this light is consist of 7 different colors. In case of white light, suppose the incident light is white light. So what happens? Same thing will happen. That is, this white light will break into its 7 constituent color. And so they will pass like this. They will pass through 7 different points. That is, red component of white light will pass through this point, and violet color will pass through this point. Or from here we can see that focal length of violet color will be minimum and focal length for red color will be maximum. You can also see this concept from the same diagram. From here, suppose it is a prism, it is a lens. So what will happen? Red color will somehow go here at a large distance, and violet color, you can see, it is here. So red color will have more focal length compared to violet color. Now we can also see the same concept with some different view. We know that 1 by f equal to mu g by mu a minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. If the lens is placed in air, so this is the focal length of the lens, or mu air is 1. So 1 by f is proportional to mu glass minus 1. That is refractive index of glass minus 1. And we knew that mu is a function of color. Refractive index of a medium is a function of color. For different color, mu will have different value. And earlier we saw here through Cauchy's theorem, we got this one, this order. That is, mu of red color will be minimum and mu of violet color will be maximum. Since focal length is inverse of mu g, so focal length of red color will be maximum and focal length of violet color will be minimum. You can also see that the same concept with this point of view. Now we will see some very important questions. So here you can see that question number one. When light travels from an optically denser medium to a rarer medium, will the critical angle of incidence depends on color of light? Yes, this is a very important concept, guys. We know that what is critical angle? The angle at which the incident ray, for which the refracted angle is 90 degree. This angle is called critical angle. We know that sine I is equal to 1 by mu if it is air. And also I discussed earlier, mu is a function of color. If mu is a function of color, then sine IC will be also a function of color, or IC, that is critical angle, will also be a function of color. Now, since IC will also be a function of color, yes. Example, earlier we saw that mu of red color is less than mu of blue color. Therefore, since IC and mu have inverse relation, if mu will have less more value, sine IC will have less value, or IC will have less value. So critical angle for red color will be more than the critical angle of blue color. It means that if we'll pass a red color through this along it or blue color, then red color will have more critical angle compared to critical angle of blue color. Now see, next question is, this question is also very important. How does the angle of minimum deviation of a glass prism vary if the incident violet light is replaced by red light? Yes. So earlier we saw lambda of red color is more than the lambda of violet color. And through Cauchy's theorem, refractive index of red color of prism will be less than refractive index of violet color. And deviation through a thin prism, we know this formula. Deviation equal to A into mu minus 1. Since mu of violet is more than mu of red, therefore lambda of violet will be more than lambda of red color. Now come to next question. Here you can see that. How does the focal length of a lens changes when red light incident on it is replaced by violet light? First tell me, will the focal length change? Answer is yes. Why? Because focal length is a function of color. And here in the question, they have given two different color. One is the red color and other is the violet color. Now, again come to the same question concept. Lambda of red color is more than the lambda of violet color. And through Cauchy's theorem, more lambda means less mu. Or mu of red color will be less than mu of violet color. Now again the same formula. 1 by f equal to mu g minus 1. I am taking the surrounding medium as air, mu of glass minus 1, 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2, or 1 by focal length is proportional to mu of glass minus 1. Now, mu of red color is less than mu of violet color. So, focal length of red color will be more than focal length of violet color. So, focal length will decrease. This we already saw earlier also, that focal length of red color will be more than the focal length of violet color. Now come to next question. This question is very, very important. Out of blue and red light, which is deviated more by a prism? Again, the same concept. Lambda of blue color is less than the lambda of red color. Red color has maximum wavelength. Now by applying Cauchy's theorem, we can see that more lambda means less mu, or mu of blue color will be more than mu of red color. Now, angle of deviation formula is what? A into mu minus 1. Since mu of blue color is more than mu of R color, and somehow more mu means more delta. Therefore, delta of blue color will be more than delta of red color. Now, come to next question. This is the last question for today's topic. For which color The magnifying power of a simple microscope is highest, and for which color it is lowest. Now, magnification or magnifying power of a simple microscope is given by M equal to 1 plus capital D by F, where capital D is least distance of distance vision objective, that is 24 centimeter. Now, lambda of red color, this is the order of lambda. Lambda of red color is maximum and lambda of violet color is minimum. And by Cauchy theorem, mu equal to A plus B by lambda square. More lambda means less mu. So, mu order will be opposite to that of lambda order. That is, refractive index of red color will be least and refractive index of violet color will be maximum. Now, again, the same formula. We know that 1 by focal length is inversely proportional to mu minus 1. Or more mu means less f. That is, focal length will have inverse order of this. So, focal length of red color will be maximum and focal length of violet color will be minimum. Now, so m will be maximum when? M will be maximum when focal length will be minimum and m will be minimum when focal length will be maximum. So, m will be minimum for f when f will be maximum. That is, for red color, magnifying power will be minimum. And minimum focal length will be for violet color. And for this, m will be maximum. That is, for violet color. For violet color, magnifying power will be maximum. And for red color, magnifying power will be minimum.